Hey, what's going on YouTube? Krosama here, and I am back. I know I took a long hiatus, but I needed some breathing room. I needed some time to relax. I took a vacation back to the state. Well, not as much of a vacation as it was a business trip over to BuildCon, which was fantastic. Unfortunately, I did not record anything while I was there because I was having too much fun talking and interacting with all the people there. It was a great time, honestly. And during that same weekend, Pokemon Sword and Shield released. And if you follow me on Twitch, you probably noticed I've been, you know, streaming quite frequently on there with Sword and Shield. Yeah, it's a pretty addicting game, and I absolutely love it. And it's just been really good to, like, you know, pick up a game and just play it and enjoy it and not really have to worry about anything. You know, with Gunpla, I do enjoy building Gunpla, but Pokemon is, like, always going to be my number one thing that I really like to get into. Gunpla is probably my number two. But I really just felt like I needed a small break. I don't think it was burnout. I just think I needed a break. So I took my break, and I'm kind of, you know, re-energized, and I'm looking at making videos once again, trying to do a daily video grind. That's going to be a little bit difficult, but I'll do my best to produce as many videos as possible and good quality videos of that. But first, let's go ahead and take a look at the analysis of the Strike-Nor. Now, also, I would like to mention real quick, right above, I do have the new type right there. I do want to give them a shout out. They're not directly sponsoring this particular type of video. They mostly sponsor my Gunpla videos. But hey, if you're getting into Gunpla for the first time, because I know a lot of people that are getting into this game really are not into Gunpla, and there's a lot of people who are getting into this game who really love Gunpla, definitely check out their website and use that promo code Krosama so that way you can get 10% off a purchase. And trust me, they have a great selection. They carry P-Bandai, they carry tools, paints, you know, normal, regular releases, even some, like, I forgot what it was, like, conversion resin stuff. I never mess with resin, but if that is your kind of niche, then hey, you can go ahead and check them out. But today we're taking a look at this suit, and man, I have loved this suit since I first got into Gunpla. Second time got into Gunpla, let's say that, back in 2011. I saw the Master Grade of this kit, and I still own that kit to this date. Very solid. It is based on the 1.0 Strike Gundam. It's solid. I mean, it's beautiful. Has a lot of great, I would say, items, you know, different weaponry that's going to come with it. Most notably is going to be those pistols, which I know is going to be an EX skill. Unfortunate. But, yeah, I really do hope they come out with dual pistols or dual weaponry like that in the future. But, yeah, it looks beautiful in-game, in the Gunpla, in the OVA, which was in the Stargazer OVA. Looks beautiful, man. I absolutely love it. So, let's take a look at all the different parts. So we'll take a look at the head, and you're going to notice that this is going to be a speed attribute. Really good looking suit. I mean, I can't stress that enough. Now look at the shot attack. 2300 is actually really good for a default 3-star. That's definitely noteworthy. And I mean, we've seen some default 4-stars that are kind of lacking in that shooting department. And you obviously know that the head is going to be primarily the shooting attack stat. So this is just going to have the basic EX skill with the head Vulcans. Nothing new here. And with the body, we have some really decent stats for the armor. Shot defense is going to be really up there. Doesn't look too bad. I mean, obviously, the rest of the stats are pretty lackluster, but I still think they are fine. Look at the parts traits with Dual Sabers category equipped, which it does come with. EX skill damage output boosted by 20. I really wish that was like normal damage, because each individual hit, you know, from a normal attack being an extra 20 would actually be pretty decent. But with the EX skill damage output, if you're doing like a one hit, or even if it's five hits, I mean, that's only an extra 100 damage. I don't think that's really impressive at all, so the body is honestly not great. Okay, let's take a look at the arms. Not horrible, actually they are pretty horrible. I'm looking at that attack stat, I'm just, yeah, that's not impressive. And obviously the arms are most notably known for the melee attack stat. So with that lacking, it's like this thing better be coming with a solid parts trait. So let's take a look what that is. With speed attribute, which it is, melee crit rate boosted 17%. That's okay, but I've seen this done better on other parts. Parts that were not, like, horribly crippled. And it says melee crit, so it's like, you want us to get these crits on the melee, but, I mean, are you really going to sacrifice all this melee attack? This thing really should have had, at minimum, I personally would say, at least 2,000 melee attack. It's going to have a lot of good a lot of good weaponry that's going to support that, even though, you know, it really just has the blades. So, I guess it's not really focused on melee, but man, I don't know, like, it's going to have the blades, so why not focus on the melee attribute, but, or the melee style, but honestly, the parts trait's not too bad. You really have to have a solid weapon, which I don't think those dual blades are going to be solid. But if you did have a solid, you know, weaponry with it, hey, you're going to get some good crits. Okay, so now with the legs. I'm not feeling it, man. I'm not feeling it. This is like super disappointing right now. But yeah, the shot defense is good, but everything else is just so average. Looking at the beam rifle, shorty, so you got beam shot, piercing is A, which is really good, power is D, which is really good, so fire the twin pistols on your legs. I don't know how many times it you know, does damage, like how many times you shoot, if it's just like 1-1, or if it's like rapid, I'm not too sure, so we're definitely gonna take a look, but the cooldown is really good. I mean, 3-second initial, you're popping this off immediately, so that's a really good EX skill if it holds up in the battlefield. We'll see how it looks. I can't really gauge the damage output, just because I'm not going to max it out right now, but it looks like it's going to be pretty decent. And take a look at the backpack. Honestly, the backpack's decent. These kind of stats are pretty good for the backpack. Normally, it's like, when you see these kind of stats on like arms and all that, you're really losing me. But these stats, the defenses is not too horrible, so I'll take that. Now, I'll take a look at the EX skill. You got the dual linear guns. Physical shot, which is really weird. You got beam shot for one, now you got physical shot. I don't care for that change, but obviously if that's how the mobile suit is, that's how the mobile suit is. You got piercing, which is D, power B plus, magazines is 7, so this is pretty decent. You know, obviously you're gonna have this initially roaming around shooting your weaponry. B plus is actually pretty good. It's really hard to get an A in power or piercing when it comes to those like magazine rounds. So I'll take B plus any day, and it's probably not gonna be too bad. And for the weapons, we are going to have the dual blades looking really solid, except for that melee attack. I mean, it's not the worst, because there's a lot worse out there. But it's definitely, I'm not seeing anything impressive with those stats right now. 1700, it's lackluster. I got a mace. I got a super powerful mace with a super powerful EX skill. What does this bring into the table? So maybe this is just something that's good for people who don't have the luxury of those parts, but I really wish there was a way to kind of scale this up, like third party style, or like maybe I could take the mace, take all the stats from the mace, and you know, I forgot what the terminology is in World of Warcraft, but you can like transmute it, I think that's what it is, and make these have the same exact stats, maybe not the same EX skill, but at least the same stats as the mace, but by sacrificing my mace. I will do that for an actual cool looking weapon. But that's not, maybe at that point you're making a broken game because the meta is going to be all over the place. But we're not even doing PvP, so I don't know. But the parts trait is 12% chance of attacks penetrating super armor. That's pretty good. That's going to be helpful whenever you're dealing against bosses when it comes to multi-raids, I would assume. And if you have really bulky mobile suits in the arenas, this should actually help. But I don't know what the DPS is. I'm not too familiar with, I don't know much about the scaling of damage when it comes to dual blades, just because I wasn't currently playing during this time frame. So we're going to test it out in the battlefield. Now this does not come with a long range weapon, even though I know the Master Grade, it has a rifle. It has a really nice rifle, in fact, so I don't know why they didn't include that with here. And of course it doesn't come with a shield. Now you got your Pilot 7. He's pretty cool. I mean, we do have it's an owl fighter, so it's like, it's looking okay. The melee attack's 800, it's not super bad, but it's all about the parts traits, man. So with speed attribute self, initial EX skill charge boosted 12%, hey, that's not too bad. Although two of your EX skills are already gonna be like, you know, one's 3 seconds, one's 0 seconds. So your initial EX skill charge is really gonna be for, you know, what, your head Vulcans? No, not even the head Vulcans. Let's check it out. It's going to be for, no, the backpack 0, the pistols. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of pointless because this even takes no time, 5 seconds. So I don't want to say that's a wasted, trait, but I guess it'd be good for whatever your weapon or shield is, or if you're doing some customizable stuff, then obviously. But yeah, that's, I don't know, man. That's not, it's good. I just don't think it's good for this particular suit. Now, for word tags, you are going to have Gundam type. So, raises armor 5% and physical resistance 5% while active. This is going to be your only word tag that is going to be active. And you're going to get 6 of them. So, every part is going to have a Gundam type. Then you're also going to have 4 space. So, if you get, you know, either a pistol, you know, whatever your long-range weapon, or a shield that has 4 space, you get to activate that. And it can raise your parameters all the way from 1% if you're not in a space terrain, or 3% if you're in a space terrain. You got 4 Tundra as well. And I really hate how they split that like that. Why are you gonna make me choose between 4 Tundra and 4 Space? I don't care for that. And then 7, he's just all over the place with his stuff. I mean, he helps with the 4 Space, but high mobility, that's just a wild card just thrown in. I don't get that. But anyways, hey, you got Gundam types. That's not really gonna be too horrible. And we do have our EX skills set, so we got 3. Let's go ahead and take this bad boy into the arena. Not the arena. Wow, the missions. Now, one thing I did forget to mention, I think this is going to be more notable to actually go and mention, you know, further on. But let's take a look at the stats real quick. So the stats, although I kind of tainted it with the 2 extra weaponry, so kind of ignore that. But you can still see the scaling. This thing is going to have a lot of good defenses. I would say the shot defense overall is going to be better. The melee defense is only good because of the GN shield. That's exclusively the only reason. But yeah, it's... I would say if you're going to use any gear, looking at everything, maybe you're going to want to boost up your shot attack. Mainly, this is the reason why, because most of your EX skills, actually all your EX skills, are shot based. So raising it, raising your shot attack is definitely going to assist you in just maximizing your damage output. I know melee is pretty tempting, but you're really just going to be focusing on that that shot because it's your EX skills as well. So you're probably going to want to go with your shot attack, and then secondly, maybe go for melee defense since your shot defense is already going to be really good. We can go ahead and assist that that melee defense, that way it can just help it. But if you want to just really maximize your shot defense, you can do that as well. But those are the 2 I would probably recommend you going for. Okay, so right here my mic actually went out, which is unfortunate. I really wish I would have noticed beforehand. But yeah, I'm just using this mobile suit in the mission, and it handles and plays, you know, much like most of these, kind of like Exia, to be honest. It really has the same feel. And here I use the head Vulcans, which look good, and I use those pistol EX skills. Boy, it just looks so flashy. Now, using the cannons on the wings or the binders, those are really great. I actually really enjoy using those probably the most because they do some massive damage because they're shooting, you know, 2 of the shots at the same time. And of course, if you just, you know, use any kind of like power-ups, much like the Tall Geese 2 head, or if you use any kind of passive traits that are going to increase, you know, the EX skill, you know, piercing or shot attack, I think you're gonna pull off some massive damage just from these like multi-shot attacks. And that's something I really enjoy with this mobile suit. I love the pistol maneuverability right there. Like, it's the same thing as in Gundam Versus. It just looks really solid. So let's take a look at a custom build. Okay, so with a customizable suit, this is what I went with. I basically went with the Tall Geese head. And the reason behind that is because I wanted the offense increase. And I also went with the new Gundam's body, the Strike Arms, and I think I just kept the shield. Yeah, I kept the shield and the rifle the exact same. And I also changed the pilot. Oh, I got a long hold on it. So I'm going to show you who the pilot is. So it's Garma, Zabi. Basically, you just wanted that speed attribute. So buff EX skill time up 1%. I mean, it's not really like the best, to be honest, but I thought it was a little bit better than what we already had, and it's also a mid-shooter, so I felt like this, I really wanted to emphasize on the shooting aspect. I could have went the cheap route and just got Amuro Ray, but I was like, you know what, let me choose this, something that's a little bit more realistic. So the only like real high items on here is going to be the new Gundam body, maybe a lot of OGs, you know, they already had the body, or at least, you know, some parts of the new. You're also going to have the Airstrike Gundam, which is going to be the arms. You get the Gian Sword Rifle mode, and you're also going to have the Gian Shield Exia. So a lot of these are going to be the speed type, which is going to be super damn good. But I do love the color scheme. I chose... what did I choose, actually? It might have either been the... No, it wasn't a dual Gundam. It was... Actually, let's go ahead and check right now. Let's go to painting. And it should be highlighted. The Stargazer. So I chose the Stargazer for the overall kit. And then for the backpack, I chose the Gian Archer. I like the red backpack. I thought it looked pretty cool. So, yeah, went with those two. And, yeah, I think it looks pretty good. Now, oops. Even though I have the Do Not Disturb on, it still, you know, slimes right in. So I still kept the Gundam type. We're going to really keep that. We did keep the other two EX skills. So we do have the Tall Geese 2 to get our shot attack increase. But we kept the other two because they're really good EX skills, to be honest. And they're shot attack, so hey, definitely get that boost. Now, some of the little word tags. I mean, the new Gundam, when attacking with beam shooting power, it's boosted by 17%. So that's going to help with the pistols because those are beam oriented, and also the Gian Sword Rifle, that is a beam weapon as well. With speed attributes, special shot power boosts 17%. So if you just long hold on the rifle like button, you can do a special shot, which is going to be much stronger. Then I really wouldn't pay attention to the Gian Sword. I mean, armor's 40% or more, enemy's strong melee power reduced 17%. It's good for a long distance shooter because you really don't want to get ran up on by a Barbatos. When armor is 40% or more, EX skill damage output boosted by 9. It's kind of garbage. But yeah, this is the set I came up with, and if you really like it, I mean, you could definitely go ahead and copy it if you have all the parts necessary. But yeah, I thought it looked really decent, but I'm not really needing to showcase it. I mean, it's performing pretty much the exact same way as the original suit. Just you got an offense up and you got some better attributes. But yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. So I think this suit is actually worth getting. What I would say, the parts to go get, maybe the head. I would say golden up that head, even though it does have Vulcans. Vulcans are still pretty good, just to get some defenses down, but it has really good shot attack. I would say go for that. The arms and the body, I don't think were fantastic, to be honest. Especially the arms, I don't think the arms are good at all. Probably the backpack is going to be really good, so pick those up. I would say gold those. The legs has a really cool EX skill, but I don't know. I don't know if it's worth it. I'm going to go ahead and gold it just because I really want to see it. I don't think the swords, the dual blades, are really good. They look cool, but I'm pretty much going to keep them blue. I might just buy a bunch of blues, and eventually I'll get it to a gold. But for right now, the ones I'm going to go for, the straight gold, is going to be the backpack, the legs, and the head. So those three are really good, and that's probably what I'll recommend you going to get. But other than that, guys, that's pretty much it for me. So definitely thank you all for watching. If you have any questions, definitely ask me in the comment section below. I love the Strike Nor, so it's I kind of hate shitting on some of the parts, but hey, facts are facts. But can't wait to see what the next event's gonna be. That's something I'm kind of looking forward to, because not saying this event's lackluster, it's really nice, it's really fun. I do love the point assessment, but I really want something that's gonna like really grab me, and this event did grab me. But let's go ahead and get something that's a little bit more engaging. But that's it for me, guys. Definitely thank you all for watching. I'm really glad to be back, and I'll be seeing you in the next video. Bye-bye.